In this lesson, we'll take a look at two examples of determining the domain and range of a relation, and then determine if the relation is a function. In these examples, the relations are given as sets of ordered pairs. Recall, each ordered pair is in the form of x, y. So again, we want to find the domain and range of the relation given by these five ordered pairs, then determine if the relation is a function. For a quick review, recall the domain is the set of all inputs, which are often x values, and the range is a set of all possible outputs, or y values. And then finally, a function is a relation in which each input has exactly one output. To find the domain, we look at the x values, or the first value of each ordered pair. We have -3, -2, -3, -3, and -2. If a value occurs more than once, we only list it once when giving the domain. In this case, a domain, in order from least to greatest, is -3, -2. And now to find the range, we look at the y values, or the second values, of each ordered pair, which are 7, 7, 5, 3, and 5. Again, we don't list any of the values more than once. In order from least to greatest, the range is 3, -5, -7. And now again, the relation is only a function if each input has exactly one output. While analyzing the ordered pairs, if we focus on the domain of x equals -3, which occurs in this ordered pair, and this ordered pair, we can see the input or x value of -3 has more than one output. It actually has three outputs. It has an output of 7, an output of 5, and an output of 3. And therefore, the relation is not a function. It's also not a function because notice the input of x equals -2 also has more than one output. It has two outputs. The input of -2 has an output of 7 as well as 5. Another nice way to test to see whether a relation is a function is to map the relation where we list the elements in the domain in the first set, the elements in the range in the second set, and then draw an arrow to represent each ordered pair. Let's also show this. So again, to show this, the elements in the domain are -3 and -2. The elements in the range are 3, 5, and 7. The ordered pair of -3, 7 indicates when the input is -3, the output is 7, and therefore we draw an arrow from -3 in the domain to 7 in the range. For the ordered pair -2, 7, we draw an arrow from -2 to 7. For the ordered pair -3, 5, we draw an arrow from -3 to 5. For the ordered pair -3, 3, we draw an arrow from -3 to 3. And for the ordered pair -2, 5, we draw an arrow from -2 to positive 5. Looking at the mapping, it's much easier to tell this is not a function now because the input of -3 has three outputs, not exactly one. And the input of -2 does not have exactly one output, it has two outputs. Let's look at our second example. To find the domain of the relation given as a set of ordered pairs, we look at the x values, which are the first values of the ordered pairs. We have -5, -3, -1, 1, and -2. Notice there is no repetition. The domain, in order from least to greatest, is the set with elements -5, -3, -2, -1, -1. And now to find the range, we look at the y values, which are 4, 4, 4, 4, and 1. Again, we only list 4 once, and therefore the range is the set with elements 1 and 4. And now recall, the relation is a function if each input has exactly one output. Notice -5 has one output, -3 has one output, -1 has one output, 1 has one output, and -2 has one output. It's okay that -5, -3, -1, and 1 have the same output. All the inputs have exactly one output, and therefore the relation is a function. To better understand this, let's also map the relation. Again, to do this, we list the elements in the domain in the first set, which again are negative 5, negative 3, negative 2, negative 1, and 1. And the range contains the elements 1 and 4. For the ordered pair negative 5, comma 4, we draw an arrow from negative 5 in the domain to 4 in the range. For the ordered pair negative 3, comma 4, we draw an arrow from negative 3 in the domain to 4 in the range. For the ordered pair negative 1, comma 4, we draw an arrow from negative 1 to 4. And for the ordered pair 1, comma 4, we draw an arrow from 1 to 4. And finally, for the ordered pair negative 2, comma 1, we draw an arrow from negative 2 to positive 1. Looking at the domain, notice there's only one arrow leaving each element in the domain, which means each element in the domain, or each value in the domain, has exactly one output, which is why the relation is a function. Again, it's okay that four of the elements in the domain share the same output as long as each element in the domain, or each input, has exactly one output. I hope you found this helpful.